of the United States. Mm-hmm. And as we see, not in the Supreme Court of the United States. Mm-hmm. Safety is in Jesus. So Jesus prays for the disciples. And then he prays, the next slide, he prays for you and me, right? The disciples, okay, now go back. The disciples, you can fill in the blank. He is the disciple who make disciples. Okay, what are we saying? Disciple is a very simple concept. It's a follower of Jesus. A disciple is a follower of Jesus. And what in John 17, 20 to 26 is here, Jesus is praying not only the ones that he's ministering to, his disciples, but then it's the one who believe. That's us, who heard the word. So there are two categories of disciples there, but basically it's the disciple that Jesus ministered to, but also the ones who believed after because of the disciples and what they did. They preached the gospel, the good news. And so Jesus prays for you and me for their safety. And so the hard question for you, and maybe not as hard, the easy question is, are you a disciple? Are you a follower of Jesus? Verse 20, let me read. I do not ask for these only, but also for those who will believe in me through the word, that they may all be one, just as you, Father, are in me, and I in you, that they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. Very clear. But this unity, if you read it carefully, there's a prerequisite. We are in unity with the apostles, the early disciples that followed Jesus, and we together, and then we're all in Jesus and in the Father, the Holy Spirit, the triune God. You see that? So you don't exist by yourself. This weird American idea of me and my horse, I'm going to ride to the sunset, right? It's not working. It's not real. And so you need to be careful and pay attention to that. But it's not you. It's you in the family of God. Very critical. But here's something that's missing, and a lot of people are really misunderstanding this. If you are united with the apostles, the teachings that's written in you, that means you embrace what is being taught theologically about God, what it means, the scripture, the definition of marriage, all has to be in here. So there is no unity if you throw this out. You get it? But people don't want to talk about it because they want to say, all we need is love, love, love. Of course you need love, but which kind of love? You have no right to define what love is. Only God can define what is love.
Amen.
And as we sang, it's holiness. Is this what we seek? So remember, this is what the wicked world is doing. Playing games with our mind, but redefining the definitions. Are you a disciple? So, you're sitting here, you ask me, okay, so how do I know if God has given me this grace? How do I know? How do I know that I've been saved by grace and through faith? Okay, and that was the last time in June I preached Hebrews 11, right? Where it says faith in Hebrews 11 is almost, it's like faith that you want Jesus more than anything else. Saving faith is inside out faith. In other words, it's a matter of your heart. A changed heart. And yet how many of you have kids? Kids, okay? If you have kids. Sure, you work with their behaviors and attitude, right? As when they're young, they do something bad, you deal with it. But you know that it's only outward behavior. But always focus on the heart, right? Because they're kids who grow up, and they're good kids. We call it compliant child, right? They'll do everything you say, but in their heart, they haven't changed. They're ready and waiting for them to leave. And then when they leave the house, they do their things. Okay, so that's why, okay, saving faith here is that that's why you need to pray. It's a matter of prayer dependent. Always trust on God's Holy Spirit. Because ultimately, it's not our work. You see, a lot of people, there's another false thinking here. They're saying, you got to love them, you got to do these things, you got to be relevant, you got to accept them so that they would. Baloney. The scripture's clear. The work of God, the Holy Spirit, the triune God would call them and select them. We do the speaking and the serving. It's not our responsibility. Whether they, in faith, accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Psalm 127, right? Unless the Lord builds the house, the laborers labor in vain. So if you say you belong to Jesus, let me ask you, does that change the way how you live? Share with me one thing you've been reading the Bible recently that you realized you've got to change. Okay?
Don't take God's name in vain.
Great. Anyone else? When was the last time that you have shared with somebody about Jesus and how Jesus has answered your prayers? Okay? How Jesus has made a difference in your life. This is kind of like a reality check if in fact you have a relationship with Jesus. Or you think you have. Our earthly journey requires, yes, a relationship with God, but also with the family of Jesus. Ask yourself the question, are you involved in this church? Are you involved in branch community? You're doing all these ministries in short-term, long-term ministry with this church, the local church? If you're not, then honestly, I'll be honest with you. You should question yourself if in fact you have a relationship with Jesus. Because you're in Jesus and you're in the family of God. That's the definition. You're just basically getting to know Jesus. Because whether you belong to Jesus, then you're not belonging to the wicked world. It begins with your heart. Are you willing to have this kind of faith? This is God's grace. You say, Lord Jesus, I know how, where, who, by faith, I put my trust in you. And if you're praying this prayer, like, you know, some of you, I wanted you to ask this question. And I wanted you to seriously consider having you think and pray and look at your heart of your faith and your relationship. Who amongst you here say that you're a follower of Jesus? And you already made that decision. I want you to stand. Stand. Close. How many of you, at this point, you feel, okay, I know that. But when Pastor Young asked those questions about sharing my faith or learning new things from Jesus and trying to change and live my life, and I don't really am connected to the family of Jesus. And so obviously I'm short. And you know, last week Pastor Steve preached Acts 15, right? And he said that our God is a God of second chance. And Jesus is God of the second chance. It's never too late to run to Him. And so this morning I ask you, are you a father?